it is true that India is the most diverse country in the world, culturally, linguistically and gastronomically. Yes, my friends, you heard it right. Don't we Indians just love our food? But I've often wondered how many of us know the history of food in India, especially some of our staples. In today's episode of Culture Shauk with me, Sunita Iyer, let's trace India's food journey that goes back thousands of years as we celebrate World Food Day today. Historically, two crops common to every agricultural civilization are cereals and pulses. Fruits, vegetables, and dairy products supplement these core elements. In modern India, grains provide around 70% of India's calorie intake, but which grains were grown and consumed changed over time. One of the earliest grains was barley, which was consumed during the 2nd millennium BCE in India. The Indus Valley civilization, which flourished from around 3000 to 1500 BCE, saw the production of wheat and barley in surplus, with the latter finding mention in the Rig Veda. According to archaeologists, wheat was ground and most likely baked in round clay ovens, similarly to today's tandoors. Flat metals and clay plates resembling modern tawas have been found in plenty from Harappan sites, suggesting that baked chapatis may have been prepared. Sweetening came from honey, dates and jaggery. The Indus Valley people also grew lentils and other pulses like chickpeas, black and green gram, and fruits like pomegranate, coconut and banana. In the southern part of the subcontinent, the staples were indigenous pulses and millets around the 2800 to 1200 BCE. Archaeological finds indicate cooking involved large-scale grinding and boiling. In western India, traditional grains were sorghum and millet. Domestic consumption of millets had fallen sharply since the India's Green Revolution of the 1960s. But recently, there has been a resurgence of interest in these grains owing to its health benefits. Rice has been the main grain consumed in eastern and southern India. One of the most important components of Indian food waste is the widespread consumption of lentils. The lentils grown in India have different origins. Pigeon peas, or popularly known as tuar dal, originated in central India, while urad and moong dal were cultivated in the grasslands of South India around the 3rd millennial BCE. Chana dal, masoor dal and green peas came from Western Asia to the Indus Valley at the same time as wheat and barley. The quintessential feature of Indian food is of course the extensive use of spices. Some that are indigenous to India are ginger, turmeric, tamarind, black pepper, curry leaves, green and black cardamom and holy basil or tulsi. Archaeological findings confirm that between 2500 and 2000 BCE, turmeric, black pepper and ginger was extensively used during the Indus Valley civilization. Almost all spices used in India have Sanskrit names, indicating their extremely long usage. Spices that arrived from Western Asia in the very distant past included cumin, fenugreek, mustard seed, saffron and coriander. Cinnamon from Sri Lanka and cloves and nutmeg from Indonesia reached India starting in the 3rd century CE and were later cultivated in India. While it's interesting to know that India's food trail goes back thousands of years, what is more interesting to note is that Indian food is different from rest of the world. It reflects a perfect blend of various cultures and ages. Just like Indian culture, food in India has also been influenced by various civilizations which have contributed their share in its overall development and the present form. Thank you for watching this episode of Culture Shauk. Stay tuned to My Nation for more such videos.